Hello and welcome, veg embracing viewers, to Vegetarian Elite on Supreme Master Television. Last week, we had the pleasure of visiting world-renowned Yogini, Adidas global ambassador and vegan, Rainbeau Mars, as she shared her home and insights into the contemporary lifestyle of the ancient practice of yoga. Rainbeau divides her time living in Los Angeles, California, USA, with her world travels instructing yoga. She has been featured on countless covers and pages of international publications. Her extensive star clientele list has names like actor Woody Harrelson and tennis legend Steffi Graf. On today's program, Rainbeau explains how the athleticism of yoga and spirituality go hand in hand.
My yoga teacher, Chuck Miller, who is someone who is a great teacher of mine and who I ended up apprenticing and assisting, he came up to me and he's like, what does Rainbeau want to do with her life? And I was like, I don't know. And I guess I'm here to love myself enough, to learn how to love myself enough so I can teach people how to love themselves. Mm-hmm. And
it's beautiful.
Yeah. And I still can see how that all manifested. Whatever it is, we have to connect with something that is more infinite. And when you find that connection, no one can take that away.
Exactly.
That's the depth of everything that's going on in the planet, everything, the shifts that constantly happen. If you go inside and you have peace with that and you know yourself, it's easy. It's so much easier because everything can change and you still have something that no one can take away. Most important, though, most valuable is that thing that is there beyond even my body, and I let go of who I've become to be who I am. There's the big me and there's the little me, just in child forms. And the big me is our infinite self, and the little me is our ego. And our ego says if we force it, if we control it, we'll have it our way. And the big me is going to know that each person is doing exactly what they need and we can't control them and they're exactly where they need to be, and we have compassion and love and we respect our unique personality, but we don't let it be run by our mind. We're feeling rather than thinking what would be good for everyone rather than what we think in the moment would be good for ourselves. Just my own personal prayers, not my will, but thy will be done, not my will, but thy will be done. And we all really ultimately want to be our big me. And just simple, even beyond like visualization, what I do with the kids at school is like, we breathe out the little me. And so it all comes back to breath. We take a deep breath. And then you, yeah, and then you breathe in the big me.
I like the big me.
And then you breathe out the little me. And that's the ego, and that's the control, and that's why yoga, it just, the breath and why we lift our hands and you breathe in your big me and then you breathe out your little me. They say, all the spiritual masters say, that we are all one, that I am you and you are me, mm-hmm. and we are it. But we are here to really remember that. It's not easy for us. If we woke up knowing all of these things and seeing the world like that, then we would already be enlightened and there wouldn't be this human experience. Rumi, the great poet, said, if my hand was always open or always closed, it would be stiff. So this is, to me, the human experience. We remember, we forget, we remember, and then when we remember, it's a gift. Really, that's what I'm here to do in my own personal practice, is to illuminate myself from the inside, to see the miracles on this planet that exist before us. be the best version of ourselves that we possibly can is to consistently see life through the eyes of a child.
Do you see a global change on people?
I feel that right now in the shifts in the planet, kind of what we talked about before, more than ever, people are needing to feel a sense of community. Everyone is starting to put their value on what's really important right now. Like, we could keep spending our money on the cycle of overconsumption, or we could vote with our dollars and spend money on supporting companies that do want to take care of the planet, or will teach us how to take care of ourselves, or, you know, how we can learn how to cook and nourish ourselves and nourish our family and not instantly look for doctors only to fix us. We need to take back responsibility for what's going on in our lives, our bodies, our health, our families, our jobs, and allowing ourselves to be the reflection of what we want to be in the world. We give more of what is really real and really valuable, more connection, more love, more friendship, more community, more health. And, you know, we use our resources to awaken ourselves and each other and to really feel that we are on one world, that this is this precious pearl. I do know that that our biggest job is to awaken ourselves. So my dream for the world is simple. I know that if we focus on ourselves, on illuminating ourselves and taking complete responsibility, nourishing ourselves, supporting organic farming and taking care of the planet, that there will be a shift on the planet. This isn't new. Gandhi said it, Buddha said it, Jesus said it, every great teacher, we all say it. But to practice it, I really think that we're existing in a time when we are absolutely going to have to awaken, because we can't not take responsibility anymore. Not killing 50 billion animals a year could be a really big start, and that's something that you could make a choice right now. And that would be a way to live more green, live more holistically. I see at the heart of wherever I go, whatever I do, wherever I am, wherever I go, whatever country I'm in, I find that the people at the core all want the same thing. We all just really want to have peace. We want peace with ourselves. We want to know ourselves. We want to love ourselves.
When we return, Miss Rainbeau Mars will share her experience of traveling the world as a yoga instructor and developing a stylish, sustainable clothing line with Adidas. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Vegetarian Elite on Supreme Master Television. Let's now return to our interview with vegan yoga instructor Rainbeau Mars and her work with athletic global brand Adidas.
So Adidas is a very cool company. They're a German-based company. They're a global company. They have a lot of really good programs. I've been part of a women's team. I went to 13 countries teaching many different people, up to 3,000 people in one room in Brazil. That was incredible. So the campaign has been play yoga. Last year it was play yoga, play a sport where your success is measured in breaths and millimeters, and where you break your own records, and where you're captain, coach, and cheer squad. So they really like that. Play a sport where it'll help you do whatever you do it better. Yoga is one of the fastest growing sports in the world globally. And so they, from a very authentic perspective, wanted to be able to give those practitioners clothes that could make a difference in their practice and make a difference in their sport of yoga. And I've been consulting for the whole women's line for the last 2 years and helping them. I've said, you know, I like this fabric or I don't. And so that's why naturally we came up with my own signature line, because I felt that it was very important to use sustainable fabric. So it made sense to do a Rainbeau Mars signature line. I'm actually wearing it, and you can't really see it but from here, but that says Rainbau Mars, and that's an Adidas logo.
It's
and this
beautiful.
Is all,
I love it. And this is soft.
Yeah, it's super soft. It's sustainably harvested eucalyptus and recycled rubber on the shoes and organic canvas and hemp on the shoes. And then I'm also always developing content with them. They really have the Ryoka system. They like it so much that they've called it Adidas Yoga.
After these chats about yoga, we were excited to try it for ourselves. Go and grab your exercise mats. We're going to step into the back house studio and do some yoga with Rainbeau Mars.
So we're opening the soles of our feet as well, and let's just inhale and reach out, like expand from the core up to the fingertips. And then as we exhale, we'll round the back, bringing the belly button towards the spine, massaging out the back of the neck. And then inhale, come up. And then you can add this little wrist thing, because a lot of people have wrist things. So I like to push the wrist together, and do a little spin. There we go, and then exhale. So I think of my body like a sun, and when I exhale, I draw back into the center. And as I inhale, I illuminate out like sun rays in all directions. We'll reach the hands forward and do a similar type of thing. So staying on the soles of the feet keeps the feet open, which open all the organs and the map of the body. I inhale, get long, and then on the exhale, all the way out, and then bring the belly button towards the spine to massage out the internal organs.
Rainbeau shows us a bit of Ryoka, her own creation of contemporary yoga, melding with elements of martial arts and core conditioning.
Then we're just going to do three really fast, double time. So you go. Okay, that's just three. And then you're going to twist. So you can bring your hand to the inside of the leg or outside. And again, so that's all for detoxification. I could do many more of those. Okay, and release, and then just for a little bit of a core lift, you can bring your hand to the both sides of that front leg and lift up the leg, belly button towards the spine. Good, lift. Eventually, this becomes easier. And I always just bow to my body for this temple, this vehicle, my teacher. And then, of course, I always bow, you don't need to, but I always bow to my students that I salute you with my whole being. And then my hands at the heart means the light in me bows to the light in you. That's what the word namaste is. So we say namaste. I do my head so that my thoughts remain impeccable, my mouth so that my words are the same, and my heart so I can remember where I intend to come into the world through and with.
We would like to offer our thanks to the beautiful Miss Rainbeau Mars for welcoming us in her home and sharing such bright messages for a hopeful world. And to our admirable audience, we'll see you again next week on Vegetarian Elite. Coming up next on Supreme Master Television is Between Master and Disciples. May sunshine and smiles forever light up your life.
If you want a healthy, supple, and strong body, eat vegan. Bye. One life, you got to do what you should. One life.